William Morrow and Harper Audio present With a Kiss We Die, a novel by L.R. Dorn. Performed by Therese Plummer, January LaVoy, Lucas Cheng, Kirsten Hoy, Vikas Adam, Lisa Flanagan, Gabra Zackman, Fred Berman, Lauren Fortgang, Hilary Huber, Dan Bittner, Jared Webb, Joan Cheam, Angel Villalobos, Amaris Canada, and William Huffaker.
For those who know better than to try to get away with murder. Oh, true apothecary, the drugs are quick. Thus, with a kiss, I die. William Shakespeare, The Tragedy of Romeo and Juliet, Act 5, Scene 3.
CBS This Morning interview with correspondent Meg Choi.
I'm here with crime journalist Rianna Raines, host of The Raines Report, which became an audio sensation last October when it shot to number one on the true crime podcast charts. Her investigation into the DiCarlo Byrne murder case has drawn a record number of listeners, not only in the U.S., but in Canada, the U.K., and Australia, making it an international phenomenon. Welcome to CBS This Morning, Rianna.
Thanks for having me. You know, we're often categorized as a true crime podcast, but we think of ourselves as an audio crime investigation series. We're a core team of five, including my producing partner, a researcher, a sound engineer who does our mixing, and an editor. We conduct independent investigations and present them as serialized audio episodes.
Independent, meaning...
We're not affiliated with a traditional news organization like the New York Times or NPR or CBS. We're partnered with the podcast network Amplify. We do our own investigating, recording, and production, and deliver the network finished episodes that they market and distribute.
Before we get into the case itself, tell us about your background as a journalist.
I've always had a passion for journalism. While my friends were watching Buffy the Vampire Slayer, I was watching Barbara Walters specials. I edited my high school newspaper, majored in journalism in college, got my master's from Columbia. From there, I landed a job as an on-air reporter for WESA, Pittsburgh's local NPR station. I covered everything from city politics to human interest stories, even the occasional crime story. Then I met someone, fell in love, and altered course. My husband and I had two children, and when they started school, I started The Raines Report. We've put out six seasons and over 100 episodes in the last 4 years.
And what do you think it was about the DiCarlo Byrne case that caught such fire with listeners?
The crime isn't just murder. It's parricide, which goes back to ancient Greek tragedy and the Bible, the murder of one's father, mother, or in this case, both. And at the center of it all are these charismatic young drama students.
In those first few weeks, the hashtag Real Romeo and Juliet got hundreds of millions of views. I tuned in after the fifth or sixth episode dropped, and like a lot of other people, found myself hooked by this couple's story as they were telling it.
Jordan and Victoria seemed like the iconic star-crossed lovers. Now, keep in mind, because our investigation was unfolding in real time, I was getting to know them just 12 to 24 hours ahead of everyone else.
One. Embed. A warning. The following episodes are intended for mature audiences. They contain descriptions of violence, sexual behavior, and psychological abuse that some may find triggering.
Season 6, Episode 1. Uploaded Wednesday, October 12th.
It is better to risk saving a guilty person than to condemn an innocent one.
Amen, sister.
I'm Rhianna Rains, and welcome to The Rains Report, an audio crime investigation series produced in association with Amplify. This is episode one of a new season, a season so new and spontaneously put together, we don't have a title for it yet.
Yep, this is all on the fly. You're hearing it as it happens.
That's my producer, writing partner, co-host, and professional bestie, Jess Monet. We're recording ourselves in our downtown Pittsburgh studio because of a new message we found on the tip line of our Rains Report website.
Our tip line is a contact point for listeners who have information about crimes we're working on, as well as crimes we haven't reported on. We've received tips that have helped advance police investigations on a number of cold cases and unsolved murders.
What came in today is something different. Let's play the message.
Hi, Rhianna Rains. This is Jordan DiCarlo. You might have heard about me in connection with a murder case in San Diego. My mother and father were stabbed to death inside our family home back in June. I'm with my girlfriend, Victoria Byrne, and we'd like to speak to you as soon as possible. Please do not forward this message or tell anyone about it until we've had a chance to speak. Thank you. I love your podcast.
And he left a mobile number. Does the name Jordan DiCarlo ring a bell?
No shame Googling it. Okay, I do remember this.
We begin tonight with the discovery by San Diego Sheriff's deputies of a gruesome double homicide in the affluent North County community of Rancho Santa Fe.
Hasn't been a murder or even an assault here in years. This is a peaceful, friendly place. The DiCarlos were nice people, though they did keep mostly to themselves. We're hearing rumors about what happened up there, and it's shocking. So shocking.
We've doubled the number of private security officers and added several more patrol vehicles. All residents should exercise caution, but please know that Rancho Santa Fe remains one of the safest places in the world.
Got attention from news outlets in Southern California, nationally not so much.
Anthony and Lauren DiCarlo were days from celebrating their 23rd wedding anniversary when their lives were abruptly and horribly cut short. The killings took place inside their Rancho Santa Fe estate in North San Diego County. It's an area where large luxury properties are nestled across hundreds of acres of rolling hills and green pastures. The Homeowners Association describes the Central Commercial District as a plush yet tranquil village. Residents here include tech billionaires, sports stars, music idols, hedge fund tycoons, and many of them own sprawling ranch homes at the end of long gated driveways. The DiCarlos' only child, Jordan, a recent graduate of the University of California at Santa Barbara, went from being a figure of sympathy in his parents' deaths to a person of interest for homicide detectives to the main suspect in the crime. Also under suspicion is his 18-year-old girlfriend, Victoria Byrne. Both Jordan and Victoria were theater majors at UCSB, where they met. As far as we know, police have yet to obtain arrest warrants for them. But according to local news sources, the couple continues to be the focus of the investigation.
Publicly, investigators are keeping their cards close to the vest. They seem to be building their case one brick at a time. It's been only 4 months since the murder, so not that long.
Prosecutors like it when police go beyond mere probable cause and hand them a slam dunk conviction.
I looked up the mobile number he left on the tip line, and it is registered to a Jordan DiCarlo, currently a resident of Santa Barbara. Given this is an active homicide investigation, and it appears someone under suspicion is reaching out to a journalist who specializes in crime reporting, I'd say it's your professional duty to at least return his call.
Hello, is this Jordan DiCarlo?
This must be Rhianna Rains. I recognize your voice.
It is, and I'm responding to the voice message you left on our tip line. First of all, may I have your permission to record this conversation?
Yes, you have my permission to record me. I'm here with my girlfriend, Victoria. We have you on speaker. Do you give your permission to be recorded?
Hi, Rihanna. Yes, I give my permission to be recorded.
Where am I reaching the two of you?
In Los Cabos, Mexico.
Okay. Is the San Diego sheriff aware you're out of the country?
Yes. We didn't ask permission to leave, but we made it clear we aren't trying to escape or hide from anybody.
It's been incredibly stressful. The police, were spying on us, following us around, harassing our friends. They got search warrants, tore through all our stuff, took away our phones and laptops. They interrogated us 3 times, individually and together. We had to get away just to get our lives back.
Victoria's been staying in touch with her mom and keeping her current. We've been taking a vacation, that's all.
Have you been in communication with detectives or the prosecutor?
Our attorneys have. They know we're coming back. We just haven't told them exactly when.
Do you know if law enforcement plans to arrest you when you return?
All we know is we're their only suspects, and they say they have some kind of evidence.
But they won't tell our attorneys what that evidence is. It's like they're playing mind games with us, blowing up our lives to see how far they can push us.
Who's representing you?
Natalie Bloom from San Francisco. She's a family friend.
I know of Natalie. Haven't met her. Very accomplished defense attorney.
My attorney is AJ Novick out of LA.
I do know AJ. Excellent attorney. So you both have high-end legal counsel. And what is it I can do for you?
We're being set up for this, and we want you to tell our side of the story.
You're a truth teller, someone who's not afraid to dig deep. Our attorneys will be advocating for us. That's their job. We want someone from the outside to see what's really happening here.
Someone who's not biased, whose word is trusted.
And how do you see me telling your story?
When we land back in San Diego, we'd like you to meet us at the airport and stay with us until the moment we're arrested. We'll tell you everything there is to know about who we are and give you proof that we had nothing to do with this.
We'll answer any question. We have nothing to hide. We need to get our voices out there before...
Before they separate us and put us in jail. By then, it'll be too late.
Why not have me come out and interview you both? I could fly to California and we could talk it out over a couple of days.
We want you to get to know us, to hang out and share meals, to experience us when we're just being ourselves. If you were doing formal interviews, we'd be in presentation mode the whole time.
We want to leave a record of the real us, so you and your listeners and the world will see we're not capable of committing such a hideous crime.
As a journalist, I need to keep some distance between me and my subjects. I'd want to be clear up front. I wouldn't be telling just your side of the story.
Great. Ask the tough questions. Talk to other people about us. We'll be totally transparent.
We want to document the injustice here. 2 people getting torn apart by the legal system and having their lives changed forever.
Have you mentioned this idea of my getting involved to your attorneys?
No, because they'll be against it. They don't want us talking to anybody.
There are good reasons for that. I'm sure you know the line in Miranda that says anything you say can and will be used against you.
We're adults. We don't need our attorney's permission to talk to you. Look, Victoria and I thought about posting TikToks to explain what's happening to us and why it's harassment, but how is that not going to look self-indulgent and desperate?
People will want to hear our story before we're in custody. After that, our voices will be turned into lawyer and law enforcement speak.
A lot of true crime podcasts are about people already found guilty and sent to prison, like Adnan Syed in Serial. If you were reporting on that case, wouldn't you want the chance to interview him before he got arrested and went on trial?
You make a good point. After you fly back in, where will you be staying?
At my family home.
In Rancho Santa Fe? Where your parents...
It's my home. It's where I lived during my high school years and where I came back to during college. I know there's a plan to sell it, but not until next year.
It's the normal place for Jordan to go. He still has clothes in the closet, all his stuff from growing up.
Okay, I hear that. Who else will be meeting you at the airport or at the house?
We're only telling you. We're going to the airport tomorrow with cash to buy tickets for the flight back. The only person we want to see when we get off the plane is you. Also, Would you mind renting a car and driving us to the house? It's only a half hour away.
So there are people on this end I need to check in with, like my producer and our podcast partners. In order to jump into this, I'd have to drop everything else. I'm not saying I won't, but I need a minute to prepare.
Wow, there is a lot there. Initial thoughts?
Natalie Bloom is one of the highest profile criminal attorneys in Northern California. She's represented a lot of prominent clients in Bay Area courtrooms, including Elmer Gordon, the Silicon Valley CEO she got acquitted for the murder of his wife. Her counsel is not inexpensive. AJ is Beverly Hills stylish, loves his Rolexes and fast cars. He's also smart, highly experienced, and has a great trial record. These two have A-plus defense teams. That means something.
So you go meet Jordan and Victoria without alerting their attorneys or law enforcement. Are you breaking a law, crossing an ethical line? We'll confirm there's no warrant out for their arrest. If not, I see no legal reason against meeting them at the airport and driving them to the DiCarlo.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.